Pico here, sitting down with Tom Chilton, the game director at Blizzard. We're talking about the Mists of Pandaria, and we're asking the community of MMOC what they wanted to know, so we have a few questions from them.
Right on. Let's do it.
Let's start. Hey, we already know that the new character models are in work for old races. Do you have any idea of when players will be able to see them? And do you plan to also revamp newer races, such as the Blood Elves and the Draenei?
Right. So we definitely are slowly in progress with revamping some of the races. The reality is that at best we would get the dwarves for the Mists of Pandaria, and even that's kind of on the bubble. But it is something that we are planning to do. It's something that we really want to get to and actually believe is valuable. As to when the Blood Elves and Draenei would have that happen, they would probably be near the end of the list. We'd probably get through all the original races first before we go on to them, since they're kind of better than some of the original ones.
You think they're better? Because
yeah, in a lot of ways. Any of the ones that we've done more recently tend to be a little bit higher fidelity.
Okay. All right. Okay, so next we have, a lot of players spent most of their time rerolling characters of every class on every single server. Is there a plan to allow them for an 11th character slot?
Yes, there is. So for the Mists of Pandaria launch, we're also going to open up a 11th character slot so that players can create a monk if they want to without having to delete one of their existing characters.
That's such good news.
Yeah.
I'm really excited about that one. All right. Cataclysm brought updated water effects, shadow effects, phasing, and other small updates to the game. Should we expect more technical innovations?
Yeah, there are very subtle technical incremental kind of improvements that allow us to do more things than we've ever done before. And it really comes through if you look at the environments that are in Pandaria. For example, one of the things that we've done is we can have a higher level of detail when we are kind of painting the sides of mountains and stuff like that. So if you look at it now, the textures don't tend to look as stretched in Pandaria along the sides of kind of sheer surfaces as they used to. So that's just, it's like a small but subtle thing, but it really adds up to a lot. I think that when players look at our screenshots, or if they finally get into the beta and when Mists of Pandaria launched, they'll be pretty blown away by how good it looks overall.
I definitely noticed the textures look really beautiful this
cool.
time. Blizzard mentioned that a lot of things would become account-wide in Mists of Pandaria. Can you tell us what made that final cut and what would be applied to the entire account in the expansion?
Right. So for sure what has made the final cut is the pets. So your entire pet collection will be made account-wide. That's important because it ties into the pet battle feature that we've been introducing. So that way you don't actually have to go and change out characters every time you want to level up a specific pet or try to like re-level them for each one of your characters or anything like really annoying or grindy like that. Whereas that's the only one we know absolutely for sure, but we're still trying to make progress on the account-wide achievements. That's probably the next one that would be on the list.
Okay. Let's see. Okay, many other games over the years have implemented an AoE looting system. Is this something you guys have looked into?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, we got that into the Mists of Pandaria builds about a week or two ago at this point. So it's actually functioning in our internal builds, and we're super excited about that.
Now, how does it look? You just, you know, you click, it's like a setting?
Yeah, well, it's an option. Okay. And then when you do it, what it does is any of the creatures that are around, they're eligible to be looted. It will bring up one loot window that has all the different stuff in there. And of course, if you're set to auto loot, it's just going to take them all. So,
okay.
Yeah.
All right, let's see. Next we have, all right. Are you happy with how guild perks worked in Cataclysm? And can you give us an example of what new content and perks guilds should expect?
Right. I think we're happy with some of them. Others of them probably had, probably maybe went too far in some ways, or maybe just weren't cool enough in other ways. So I would say my overall view of it is somewhat mixed. We do expect to introduce some new perks, even if it's just to, you know, kind of swap out some of the ones that we don't feel like worked out as well.
Now, which ones do you feel didn't work out?
Well, the Have Group Will Travel, I think, is one that, while it's kind of popular, is one more thing that sort of shrinks the world and allows players to, you know, avoid actually being out in the world. And since we're trying to put more of an emphasis on players going out in the world to do stuff, that's one of the ones that we're going to replace with something else.
Is it going to be a good replacement?
Well, players will have to be the ones to make the judge of that.
Okay. All right. Let's see. Okay. When Cataclysm was released, you mentioned the possibility of allowing players to scale down their level to play with friends mm-hmm. that are maybe newer to the game. Is this something you would still like to add in the future?
It certainly is something that we'd still like to add, and we are continuing to make progress in that regard. Some of the technology that we need to do that is being created for the challenge modes. So the challenge modes get us closer to being able to do that. And that is a feature that we find very valuable, and we're hoping to see that, hopefully with the Mists of Pandaria launch, but we can't say for sure yet. Maybe it will. It might be in a patch that comes right after.
Okay. All right, we have a few more here. With one more expansion, there's even more gear for people to hold on to. Are there plans to expand features such as guild banks, regular bank slots, backpacks, void storage?
Right. Well, void storage is certainly something that we can continue to expand over time. We just added void storage. If everybody's already out of void storage space, then man, I don't know. But we do have a lot of pack rats playing World of Warcraft, so there's no doubt that guilty. There will be some players. Yeah. what a surprise. But I do think that it's a legitimate problem, and I can definitely see us adding more room to void storage as time goes on.
Okay. And is there anything else that you could share with us, maybe we missed, something you find interesting?
Right. Well, I mean, you guys got to see the demo this morning, and hopefully that got you guys really excited. Hopefully you got a chance to also play in the different builds that are going to eventually become a beta build. So I really think that we're excited to get players into the beta very soon, because that's going to be the true test of whether or not it's awesome.
Great. Well, thank you so much for sitting down with us.
Absolutely. My pleasure.